Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk about how to export Cartoon Animator 4 projects to post-editing software like After Effects in order to add visual elements to the scene and liven up the animation. The project that you see on the screen right now includes character and scene animation along with camera movement. The first thing we need to do is export this scene to After Effects. You can do this via the icon on the toolbar or else by using the render menu and selecting Export to After Effects. From here, you can click the Download Script button in order to download the script that will eventually be installed in After Effects. There's an option here to select the items that you want to include in the exported scene, which will be identical to those found in the Scene Manager. You actually have the option in the drop-down menu to synchronize the items in your export with the ones visible in your Scene Manager as well, as you can see here. After you're done selecting the objects, you can choose your frame size resolution from the drop-down menu here, and you can also choose an image resolution based on percentage values as well. If you want to enter a manual value here, you can do so in the output size section. As with regular rendering, you can also choose the export range to determine how much of your timeline will be exported. If you're running low on memory, you can choose the low memory export, which will ensure successful export. Once you've checked all of your options, you can click Export and choose a desired destination for your After Effects file. Let's take a look at the Export folder before we move into After Effects to see the files that have been exported. You can see that this includes some WAV files, which are generated from the sound effects in the project, along with a background image. If we go into our Character folder, you'll see that the character's animation has been exported as an image sequence, each image representing a frame of the character's animation. Finally, you'll find a JSON file containing further information about the project. Okay, let's get to importing our project into After Effects now. Once you have the Cartoon Animator script for After Effects installed, you'll want to click on the Import Project button in the panel and select the JSON file. A window will pop up showing the import status for the image sequence, audio, and animation. Once it's finished, you can click the Project tab to view the data imported into the After Effects project. The audio files are all here, along with the PNG sequence. However, when a prop is exported to After Effects, it will be exported as a single image with transform keys exported in order to maintain a minimum export size. Because character animation is more complicated and includes things such as expressions and hand gestures, they require an export containing both the image sequence along with the After Effects transform keys. Let's take a look at some basic editing to the project now. If you want to adjust the entire color tone for your scene, you can simply select the AE sample composition and then select the scene item from the timeline to adjust the master hue as you see here. The scene composition will contain all of the individual items in your scene, including the camera and animation keys. If we open up those tracks, you'll be able to see all of the keyframes for the camera movements, as well as the keyframes for the movement of our character. You'll also be able to see the depths of each object here as well, which is the same as using the 3D view in Cartoon Animator. Let's take a look at how to add an object to your scene from Cartoon Animator now. A new object in Cartoon Animator can be exported to the identical folder in After Effects quite easily. What I'm doing here is adding this machine part to my Cartoon Animator scene and getting it properly positioned on the Z-axis. After that's done, I'll just do the export with the same settings to the same folder, but this time only selecting the machine prop that I added. This export will contain an identically named folder with the addition of a zero in parentheses. From there, we need to import the JSON file, which will generate a new scene in After Effects containing only that machine prop. From there, what we want to do is copy and paste the object from the new scene composition into the old one. Just make sure you have the machine selected in the composition, then use the old copy and paste trick to get it in the first scene composition. From here, you can see the depth of the item on the 3D axis is consistent with the position that we placed it in Cartoon Animator 4. That's about all there is to importing your Cartoon Animator 4 project into Adobe After Effects. This new pipeline opens the door to huge possibilities for not only improving the visual quality and animation options of your scene, but it also allows you to take full advantage of all the After Effects tools to bring a more professional polish to your production. Thanks for watching, everyone. Make sure as always to check out our forums at forum.reallusion.com as well as our YouTube channel for a constant update of tutorials. I'll see you in the next video.